Aloha, we are here at the Ala Moana Park, right across from Pi'ikoi Street, the Pi'ikoi Footbridge. It's the beginning of the November 4th march against Donald Trump's fascist regime. We're going to march from Ala Moana Park up to Thomas Square. So I'm here at the beginning with Lizzie.
Drive out the Trump regime!
Coming over the bridge here. I like crossing the bridge, here we go. Thank you. Great signs here. A number of groups. Here's one of them. Get closer up on those later. We're gonna be live this whole time. After everybody crosses over the bridge, I'll follow everyone up.
I knew you had a camera somewhere. You without a camera, hey. It's like someone else being naked.
Very good. Great signs here. Hey, Will Caron. That's a good sign. Great signs here. Great signs here. I think H-Han made these signs. The funnest gig is the drum, hitting the drum thing. Hey! Dave Monix, all right. Variety of issues here. That's a good sign. There we go. Another great sign. I like that sign. Hey, hi. I like. Okay, here's the end coming up here. We're gonna go across the street here. We're marching in the streets here. We see the affirm anti-beauty queen. We are actually marching on the street. We're gonna march right through and get up to the front here. Sorry, it's a little shaky. It's a handheld camera. Walking straight up Pi'ikoi if you want to join us. kids let everybody march through our POV here. We're coming straight up Pequoy. Medicare for All bringing up the rear. Many viewpoints in this march, but all in unity. Dump Trump.
Hey, Trump has got to go.
Thank you. Here is the very end here. Fuck Trump. That's unambiguous. I love that sign. That's great. There we go. That Kenyan guy is in the march. Okay. Okay, we're going to keep doing this. Let's go up, march through the march, and see how many times we can do this. Check out the scenery here. Thomas Square. Complete distance in Thomas Square from Ala Moana is 1.2 miles, according to Google Maps. So, not a long march, certainly. We're doing now, what I'm doing now is marching through. Hello! You made it! Yay!
Yeah,
sidewalk view. Well, we can see a diversity of people here in terms of age, political point of view, sexual orientation. Just about everybody's here. It's a permitted march, apparently. The street is closed. A person up in front blowing the conch shell, the poo. And at the front, the Hawaiian flag. Blown upside down as a symbol of the nation in distress, the Hawaiian nation. I'm going to be a little careful here so I don't get run over. It would really be a shame. You see, let me push it in front here. We can see area coned off for the march. I don't know what we get number wise. I'm gonna try and get a little bit of a vantage point up here in the shade and let them pass by again. Camera facing backwards, so. I'm gonna lean up against this post so you can get some good steady shots. Maybe give you some footage from the Hawaii Gorilla video drone. There we go. That's our viewpoint from our custom engineered drone. So as I was saying, we see all kinds of people here, not only political groups united against Trump, but all kinds of people. We see even the police are in unity against Trump. Nah. One flag up front. One nation. Water protectors, Moana protectors, the Lahaina, Medicare for all, climate change activists, social activists, affirm feminists, the anti-beauty queen, and just plain pissed off there in the rear drum car here. We're going to go up the street again. We're going to keep repeating this. We're at the intersection of Pikipoi and Makaloa. And people can join us if you want to. Now this is in Honolulu in Hawaii, where it's really difficult to get people out on a march. We don't march against stuff, and unless it's a big deal. And who is this a big deal to? You know, if you look at the people, you know, as they pass, we've got all kinds of people. See somebody in a Kaepernick jersey. People from the university getting some thumbs up from bystanders. I'm on the sidewalk. We're getting up towards the front. Working up toward Thomas Square, the first public park dedicated in the 1840s by Kamehameha III, Kawakeauli, dedicated to the people in commemoration of the 1843 return of sovereignty by the British Misadventure by a British citizen, Paulette, for a short time until the country was, the nationhood was restored on July 31st, 1843, by Admiral Thomas, and that's where Thomas Square gets its name. Restored by the British Crown, and Street Beretania, named after Britain. There have been some attempts to transfer Thomas Square to the Department of Enterprise Services to create a commercial area. That has been resisted so far by the public. Couple more blocks up to the corner of Beretania, and I'll try and catch people coming around the corner. I know people are writing comments and stuff, and not reading them because it's kind of hard. There's a park across the street. Huh?
You gotta need louder speakers. Last time you guys had a cart with a loudspeaker, that's why.
Yeah, that's what we need.
You know? Never show up.
I don't know.
Remember last time you had a cart with a loudspeaker, yeah?
Yeah. It's mid Honolulu right now. This is a main thoroughfare that leads up to the freeway. A lot of traffic on it. Also, fairly densely populated residential area. It's really mid-Honolulu. Very near McKinley High School, which was formerly known as Honolulu High School. And there's a story about McKinley High School too. There's a statue of McKinley holding what they claim is a treaty of annexation. No such thing. There is not a treaty of annexation between Hawaii and the United States. A treaty of annexation has to be signed by both nations. There isn't one. So many people regard Hawaii as independent nation yet. It's the feminists. Climate defenders. Water activists. Moana activists. The anti-duty queen, of course. No treaty for fake state. I saw that. That's absolutely true. People call it a state. After annexation 1897, it was annexed as a territory then, and it was declared a state in 1959. There was never any choice to remain an independent nation. President Trump was here last night. I don't know if he's departed yet. Is it?
When you're ready, I'll go.
Okay, we're not going down Barrettania, we're going to go down King. Thoroughfares. Barrettania goes one way and King goes the other way. Barrettania goes Eva. King goes from downtown the other way. People in Hawaii are pretty tolerant of blocked traffic and stuff like that compared to other places. Lack of concern for crazy people in cars. You know what I mean. This is the path down. Some businesses here. There's a hairdressing salon. People are like, oh, what's going on? That is the notorious, infamously named McKinley High School. We're gonna walk by it. Shrine. Thank you. ride here? The guy maybe we haven't seen? In the back, get people back where they park. Okay. I like this sign. Let me show the sign. That might be my favorite sign. Classically for a Hawaii march, people are marching too fast. You're supposed to march slow, but I guess you get pumped up with the adrenaline and you start like marching fast. It's supposed to be slow, you know. If you know anybody planning a march, can you ask them to keep it slow, to keep it dense? So we're marching toward Thomas Square. Here's a Beaky station. It's a non-profit corporation that has a bike rental stands on public property. And of course these bike lanes went in rather mysteriously right before the arrival. It was some kind of deal with them. What can you say? I know a lot of people like bicycles. That's fine. I don't like the way that we're done. It's also rather hot. Hot.
I saw that early thing, get a clear shot of it.
You have the Trump and Pence sign. Surprisingly few Trump people out on the street. Because sometimes there's usually a bunch of, I would call them authoritarianists. If you can imagine for some reason. Fascism is a populist movement, but an authoritarian. Led from above. I can confirm quite sincerely that it is a hot day. Anyway, I'm going to shut up and listen. Honolulu High. Honolulu High School. There's kind of a movement to rename it, and I'm all for that. is there any candidate for governor? Candidate for governor, you're live.
How you doing? Did you see my logo and all?
Yeah, it's good, man. I like it. You're the one. Okay, I'm at the corner. I'm right across the street is Thomas Square. You can see this section's still walled off. A lot of police. These guys in the Aloha shirts and Kevlar are police. You know, nobody wants to be in Hawaii and see a sea of uniforms. So, put them in Aloha shirts. You know what I mean? Yeah, tag. Freaking tag. We're gonna walk up the street here to the open public section. This section is still walled because it's being, it's facing the Blaisdell Center, so they're gonna tourist it up a little bit, make it fancy, so at least part of the, park will look like a tourist kind of thing that the mayor wanted. The rest of us want Thomas Square to remain a public park. No commercial activity. No limits on free speech. Place where families can hang out. There we go. I'm gonna turn around, we can see where we're going. This is the Victoria Street side of historic Thomas Square, dedicated to the people by Kamehameha III, King Kamehameha III. Kawikeauli. In 1843, and right here, let's get Anne signed. Thank you, Anne. Thank
you.
How
are you? I didn't have the energy to walk all day.
You know, that's Anne Wright. We're right under the banyan here. That's a big poster here with some information about specifics about the objection to the Trump and Pence regime. And there is a bandstand here. Let's get on stage. Said it was gonna stream it, and you got it. Sorry, it was You're at Thomas Square under the banyans. Recently reopened. The mayor wanted to transfer it into the revenue generating portion of the city. The public objected, passed an ordinance forbidding it. Then the mayor got around that by not transferring it, but transferring some of the duties without actually conveying the property. So this place is being monitored and patrolled, that's the word, by not by Honolulu Police Department, but by Department of Enterprise Services security, private security. And they're rousting people that look poor, that look like they might need a place to sleep. Ooh boy, okay. Let me see. We have a stage built up there. Pretty good job. I can read some of his comments and whatnot. All right, pono ke aloha, how's it, bro? Pono ke aloha is one of the video documentarians of current Hawaiian history. So big mahalo to pono. Josh Nonga, how's it? PC Lee. I should mention, yes, that Honolulu has the highest proportion of homelessness anywhere. And it says, who is protesting against Mayor Kirk Caldwell and Governor Ige? Well, put me down for that. I've been doing that. Oh, Sasha watching from far away, maybe. Ernest Carvalho. He's running for governor. Maybe we can talk to him about some specific things. He's the only actual political figure I've seen so far on this march. I got a note here that said North Korea fired a missile. I haven't been following, so it'd be good if somebody can type something in on what the deal is with that. We're gonna stay here a while. Santos Antonio Alvarez, yeah, ditto. Terry Anderson, once occupant of South Occupy, or maybe I can call that South De-Occupy. Meta Ben, that's it. Aloha to everybody. It's a nice size crowd. In the hundreds anyway. Joy Balai, not a really big fan. Dave Sansone, absolutely true. No treaty, big state. Dan Foley. Miley Mercado, how's it? Thank you so much. Keiko watching. Hi, Habane Rios. Don Fujiyama. That's it. Bronson Khalifi brings up a point. We have a heavy rate of racism on Hawaii with the whites and the help of corporations picking our people off the lands. And it's true, a lot of the homeless people are Kanaka Maoli. And how can that be? when Hawaii is their home? How'd they get dispossessed of their home? There's 1.8 million acres of ceded land, former crown lands, which are being administered by the Department of Land and Natural Resources. That's their main asset, ceded lands, and that's where they're trying to build things like telescopes and that sort of thing. And I shouldn't say telescopes, I should say observatories. They want to build a 13th one on Mauna Kea. People have had enough. Hello, Linda Gill. Well, that's a point too. Bronson says all the freaking presidents are racist. Why only pick on Trump? Because he's the one in now, you know, maybe, I don't know. But, you know, Jeffrey Shaw, Big Island. Kelly Ray Kramer, you must be in the Midwest of the continent. Aren't you like Wisconsin or something like that?